Well, hello, welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be continue working on this project here. We're going to be putting up the walls around the utility room. So if that's something that you're interested in seeing, stick around because it's coming up.
All right, so I've already done some prep work here. I've got my plates laid out and shot down with the ram set to the floor. And then we've also already constructed the two walls. Now this wall will obviously be on this side, and then the wall with the door I've got propped up here, that will be going over here. I've also transferred my plumb lines up to the ceiling. I've shot my double top plate up to the ceiling joists, as you can see here. So standing this up is going to be quite easy. It's going to be a little tight, but that won't be any big deal. We'll just kind of push the wall over at an angle, slide it in, maybe drive it in with the sledgehammer. Shouldn't be that big of a deal. So let's flip over to the time-lapse camera right now, and we'll watch these two walls go up and get everything blocked in and secured. All right, so we got both of the walls stood up here, and that boxed in this utility room. Everything went pretty quick and smooth because I'd already laid everything out and had my walls already built. So with that done, we've got a few more items that we need to do in here, which one would be getting the natural gas supply line, which is up there capped off in the blue, moved over and down this wall. So I think what I'm gonna do is bring it down this wall cavity right here, and then I'll have a little gas manifold that will break off one to the furnace, and then one will run over for the stove supply. So the stove is down here, and I'm probably gonna put right down here in this corner the connection. So over here on my table, I've got all of my parts and pieces laid out here. I'm using this ProFlex gas supply line that you can find at Lowe's, and the other parts also are ProFlex as well. So they've got this little fitting with a O-ring and everything in there that you just made up. And here's my gas manifold. So I'm probably going to have it hanging vertically in the wall cavity, and we'll secure it off to a stud. I'll be capping the bottom, capping these two, and then I'm going to have my valves, shutoff valves for each appliance coming out of those top two ports. And then out of the end of them will be the adapter that goes to the flex pipe that we've got here. And then lastly, this will be the makeup that I'm going to use coming down the wall and sticking out for the stove. So just got those pieces just sitting on there. They're not connected yet. So to make those up, you need to make sure that you use the proper gas Teflon tape. And then there's a pipe thread sealant here that's made for gas as well. So I'll be using both of those items to make all that up. So I'm going to flip over to time lapse, and we'll just kind of watch the assembly of all that. I'm not going to bore you with putting that together. It's pretty straightforward. And then we'll go ahead and get our half inch line ran. I got to drill a hole up here in the top plate, get that ran over, and then of course down through the new wall we just put up, top plate, and then down to where the valve's going to be, or the manifold's going to be. So all right, with that said, let's get rolling. We'll flop over here to our time-lapse camera and we'll get it knocked out. All right, so I wanted to cut in here just a second and go over a couple of things that you saw on the time-lapse camera. When I put in this termination plate and went ahead and ran the supply line for the stove here, I did anchor it to the stud on the way up there, a couple of places. And if you watch right there at the end, I actually pulled the termination plate off and then moved it to this side of where my wire went through. And I got to looking, and with that pipe being so close to my outside sheathing, whenever we put siding on, I didn't want to take a chance of, you know, putting a hole in that pipe. So I just went ahead and moved it on the inside of that stud, and that should give us the clearance that we need. Okay, now back to the ProFlex pipe. This is the first time I'd used it. I had used a Home Depot product that was HomeFlex. It was real similar. So I wanted to show just a couple of things on that. It was extremely simple. But let me just show you. So this would be where that home or that ProFlex pipe would go in. So let's take this coupler off of here. And inside that, you've got an O-ring. And then there are two stainless steel pieces in here. There's one that's got a slit in it, and then there's a solid piece. So the way the directions show that, you put the coupler over your pipe first, then you're gonna take your slit piece, and it's gonna, you'll have to bend it, and it'll fit into the fourth ring on your pipe. And then you put your solid piece right over that, and then your O-ring will go in on the outside, and that will kind of hold that little bundle together. Now, once all that's done, you slide your threaded connection forward until it pushes up against that stainless steel part, and then you basically just slide it onto the connection. Now, one thing to note is down inside the connection, there is another gasket in there. So the directions say make sure that that thing exists. So basically what's happening is around that gasket is where the end of your pipe's gonna be pushing up against. And then the ring that you put on in here, that's around the ring on the pipe itself, as you tighten that down, it's gonna compress that together. So it really makes a nice fit in there. So I just wanted to touch on that for a minute here before we move on. I'm gonna put that manifold right here on this stud. So I got to drill a few holes up there. I'm gonna have one for the line I just ran, plus the one that's gonna have the 3/4 line that's back there with the blue tape on it, that's gonna come down through here. So I need to go ahead and get those holes opened up in that, and then we'll be ready to drop down the 3/4 pipe and get the manifold connected. All right, so you just watched on the time lapse. I ran the next line here that's gonna serve the furnace inside the utility room here. And let me kind of slide over here and show you what I got going on. So we come out of the bottom one here through the valve, of course, and then down, and that's gonna serve this termination plate here that's got everything set up to connect up with our furnace. And I've also went ahead and connected up a pressure gauge, as you saw earlier when I was over there working on the bench. So at this point, we want to go ahead and pressurize this system, and then we can go around and spray some water and soap on each of those connections just to make sure that we don't have any problems. So just got a nice little fitting right here that fits on the air chuck for your compressor. So I'm going to go ahead and pressurize this up. Take her up to about 15 psi. There we go, just a little bit above. So at this point, I've got everything pressurized. So I'm gonna grab a spray bottle that's got soap in it. And we're basically just gonna spray around each of our connections here just to make sure that we don't have any bubbles coming out, and we should be fine. And like we did the water system, pressurizing and checking that, we're gonna leave this thing set, you know, for a while, overnight probably, and then we'll check it again tomorrow Then once that checks out good, then we'll be ready for center point to come in and turn our meter back on. And then we'll have gas up to this point and be ready for the furnace to be set. So let's go grab the soapy water and check the connections. All right, so we're on the outside of the utility room. We were facing the other way a second ago. I'm just gonna soap up these connections here. Just make sure that we don't have any kind of bubble form. And that's what I'm looking for, is just a bubble. And that basically will just be the air pushing out into the soap. I don't see anything at the moment. All right, that looks good. Let's flop around here to the other side. Do the same thing over here, just in case there's something I couldn't see earlier. Seeing a thing, which is great. All right, let me slide down here. We got another fitting back here. Again, we're just looking for bubbles. Looks good. All right, that looks good. I've got one more over there that's gonna be feeding our stove. And I've got a couple connections up here in the attic, right here where we put that 90 coming down, and then we got a connection right back there as well. So I'm gonna go do the same thing on those just to check them. I'm not gonna bore you with that. Just kinda wanna show you what you wanna look for if you're doing that yourself. Also, I wanna make mention, if you note, this bottom supply line is a bright yellow. And the one that goes up over to our stove is kind of the orangish. The bottom's actually the Home Flex line that comes out of Home Depot. I had a little bit extra. I bought over there on the table another 25-foot roll of the orange for the Pro Flex piece. But when I started comparing the bright yellow and the orangish, they are exactly the same hose, just with a different covering. So I went ahead and just cut the extra that I had, and you can see what's left over there in the floor, and used it instead of opening up a brand new roll of 25 foot that I was basically just gonna be wasting. So we'll take it back, but I did wanna mention that if you had some Home Flex fittings and everything, look a little bit different than the way they go together, but the hose itself is the same. All right, I'll check out the other connections and then make sure everything's good and we'll be good to go. All right, well, we are pretty much finished up at this point with the utility room and the proper wiring that we're gonna need in order to get the furnace connected. You saw me just run the circuit for the power, and still got it hanging outside of the panel here, but you've seen the other videos on wiring, so I'm not going to get into that. So that's pretty much done. I've got my 18 gauge wire coming out here for the thermostat control, and then I just stuck it through that box. I'm not sure how they're going to do it once everything's set in here, how they want to route it, but I'll have it to that point at least. Yeah, that's pretty much it. There's another shot of the plenums and all the duct work up there, 3/4 inch supply line coming in, and the manifold. All right, so that's gonna wrap it up for this video on building the utility room and running the gas line for this project. Now, my next video is gonna be smoke detectors. I've got 4 smoke detectors that need to go into this house, so we're gonna be running through that process next. So appreciate you watching, share the video, like,
subscribe, and we'll see you next time.